It's been quite an effort putting this together, and I'm still not done. I don't think 20 seconds counts as early in anyone else's book, but in mine, it's quite a feat. How much am I going to be in the way here? How much do I need to do about the lighting? Quite a lot, I'm guessing. Of the room. I could hide it behind my head a bit more. Same kind of issue with the camera. You know what? I'm going to put the camera over the other shoulder. There's a lot of presumption that this is going to work. Seem to zoom out any more than that. the problem with working with a slightly larger canvas. Oh crikey. Oh, this is going to be very tricky indeed. Stay in place. My stupid fat head won't get in the way. Hey! Oh. This is exhausting, I tell you, doing all this stuff. Evening, Jason. Nice to see you. Glad you could make it along. What else needs doing? I could probably do with a change of shirt. That would probably help. And, oh yeah, let's put Twitch on. Hey, yes. That's working. There's someone with me on Twitch, which is exciting. I'm going to put on a colourful shirt. Because that always helps. Did have set up for this evening was a couple of red roses let's move this so you can have a look. Can you see past that? No, you can't because they're obscured. Oh, I'm not going to bother now. Another failure, hooray! I had a couple of red roses in a glass really. I thought let's do something Valentine's based, something about Valentine's and the whole kind of peculiar situation and having to be distanced and all those sorts of things. And then I thought no, the real spirit of Valentine's is thinking about who you really love in this world. So I thought I'd do a self-portrait. Because I haven't done one for a while, and I thought I'd get the convex mirror out, because I always enjoy doing this, and I want to do more with the convex mirror, to be honest. Always have done. It's always seemed full of potential to me. A lot of this is going to be about getting the lighting right. So there's going to be a fair bit of fiddling around before I properly get going. I think I might move this studio easel in. Maybe I could put the light on the other side of it. That would be symbolic in some way, wouldn't it? I guess it probably would. The way the ugly light is in there. So there's an idea of where everything happens. just looked directly at that light, which I shouldn't have done. Yeah. Oh, Twitch is a streaming platform. So I send this stream out to various different places. It's not just on Facebook. It goes on to Twitch and Picato and YouTube, all at the same time. I mean, I presume that's what happens. It tells me that's what's happening. If I'm honest, I don't actually check. Or even care that much. it's click and hope. That's my general approach with this stuff. I have enough to do with just trying to get my lighting right, so all the technical stuff. It's just too much. Aficionados among you will notice the Zorn palette being cleared off the palette here. A limited range of colours. It's always good fun. It's good fun to do it with subjects other than portraits as well. The Zorn palette is a good limited palette to start with portraits, because it introduces the idea of working with a limited palette in the first place. And also introduces different concepts about what colour can do, especially in terms of temperature and subtlety, I guess. My trusty box next to me. That can be in the picture too. Right. I guess I'd better start drawing. I want to make sure I'm all set before I properly begin, because I don't want to have to constantly redo things. So this is going to be definitely a blurry vision moment. Yeah, I might do a bit of tidying up of cables and things later on, but until that time, that could be an interesting part of it actually. Brushes. We need brushes, aren't I? I'll start with a big brush. I've got some black over here, I may as well use that. And I want the room to be more of a thing. I might try changing, switching this light off. Then I've got a distant light, and then local lighting. That's good. That works well. Interesting thing with convex mirrors is that your own eye. I'm going to need some different lighting for that, definitely. Your own eye is the largest part, because it changes the scale of everything as it goes along. Let's see if this can work. From that side rather than this side. Still not quite right. Maybe if I attach it to the actual easel, it will work. Mm-hmm. Or what do you think? I doubt you can see anything of me at all now. It does allow that main eye, this my right eye, to be dominant in the image. Yeah, and actually that's what this is mostly going to be about. The periphery and the way the lights play around is going to come, well, it might not even make it into the image. I can probably even get a little bit closer. A little bit. That's enough. That. And then I can offset myself so that the centre, the largest part of the image, is about here. So I'm going to put my brow line in. And that's like that. And then probably want my palette in there. Oh God, I'm rather than looking at my actual brush, I'm looking at the reflection of the brush. I kind of want the palette in here, like this. So yeah, actually that's going to move my brow over there a bit. So let's cut up these distances now. Some big shapes. That's my palette there. That's going to be the canvas. The window, the big dark window. I'll use that as a beginning point. That's going to be the palette there somewhere. So yeah. Super vague, put a bit more dark in that. This is quite a well-sized canvas, so it's not going to... It's not going to absorb much of the paint. The middle again, isn't it? I wanted it to be a bit further over. If that's my shirt, maybe the side of my head's up here. My arm is reaching out to the canvas and it's only getting to the edge of the window. And the bottom corner of the window at that. So scrub out an area above that. This could be interesting. This could be very interesting, seeing how this plays out. Just move that canvas over a little bit. Could probably do with moving this light up too. I'll do that before I go any further. I'm referring to the easel light. A bit more distance to kind of spread. Come on, don't slide down. To spread out. Everything is a massive effort to not knock everything over every time I move. Okay, yeah, a bit better. Yeah, that's window, top of the easel. This points down here, and that's going to be my head around there somewhere. My hand going through that. The other window around there somewhere. So that's my big fat head showing up there. Something like that. So my hand. Sleeve, the outside of my sleeve. Okay, there's a few shapes, and that's that easel in the background. So we've got this sort of separate picture which fits into here, this area of light. Fades out behind that, so there's a cupboard back there. And actually, this might be where I start from. So these things could change, but I've got a rough idea of the scale of things and where they're going to go. My box at a more interesting angle. Yeah. Curve that goes under the palette. Okay, don't want to get too carried away with this yet. That's actually the shape of my shirt there. Tissue. Shape there. That's going to be the edge of the sofa. Going to be the edge of the window. That slopes up like this up there. That's just the window. Still sloping here. It doesn't straighten out until this bit. That's still the canvas, that's where my hand's going to go. Locking everything under there. Fuzzy out of the window behind. Where's that angle coming out of that? Actually, which way does that curve? It curves this way. Bizarrely, the shape of this halo of light behind. I racks and storage and a door. Yeah, that seems to fit in. So I'm checking these against the sleeve and things as I go. Okay. How am I with that compositionally? I think I'm okay with that so far. Let's chuck a few lights in. I have to be very careful. And it's really, I just want to stain the surface a little bit. Where are the main lights? Palette there, that's got some lights on it. I'll be buffing all of this back. Shirt there, it's got some lights on it. It's going to be a lighter area. A bit in that window there. Actually got a bit underneath it, that's my hand sticking through it. A bit on the arm. Sense of some light coming from above here, and quite a lot in that area there. Or behind the head. That's a basic composition in light and dark. Yeah, it's the beginning. Really not expecting anyone to stick it out with this. Oh, got a few of you in there. Okay, there's a lot of subtlety in here. And getting those subtle tones in is going to be quite the feat. So blurry vision. Lights off the top. I think I could put that overhead light on again. I think we still get a difference. Just bring up the glow a little bit. Yeah, that's a bit better. whether to edit out the camera as well, that's another question. Oh. This is a tricky one. Might even need a different colour shirt. Oh, I do always seem to wear red, but it does work. Might have to change the drawing a bit here as well. No, I'm not doing a time limit on this one. So, I might just keep this one going. I think I need to be smaller and over here. I've got to change it. I want the side of my head to be in the middle. So I'm all on the other side of that. Shoulder in here like this. I'm starting from a different place now. Now the idea behind this is it's something you put on in the background while you do something else, because it's not massively entertaining. I'm introducing some little colour ideas as well, just at this early stage, just because it helps with the blocking in. So that pinkness is going to turn up here. So if that's there, this is thinner, but it's also here. That's my arm. That's where my head's going to go. There we are. So if I haven't scaled it down, which I haven't enough really. That's the edge of the canvas. That's okay. That's coming back into what I started with. Which means the palette is there, but the bottom of the palette is here. The top of it is up there somewhere. Okay. A few little adjustments as I go. Changing the shape of things a bit. The colour of the canvas is actually fine for most of the vague background colours, especially the carpet. Right. This is all going to have to move.
Get off.
What about that? And back here. Everything's going to shrink a little bit. Evening, Steve. Nice to have you along. Roughly where my head is, then that is roughly the shape of that sort of shape of the room, which weirdly does lean up. I've got to pay attention to what my eye says. That's how wide I am. Ah! Again, I'm looking at the reflection of the brush rather than the actual brush, which is no good for measuring at all. Right. That's what I should be doing. It's very distracting. I suggest you try it. Extra 1/3. So that's actually where the bookcase begins, which is good. A bit. That's the back, that's the end of the ceiling. Okay, so now I can put in my easel again. My cupboard behind is all going to go here. That's the sign in my head. I know it's all looking a bit Francis Bacon at the moment, but it will So yeah, just in case you missed it, I tried to point it out at the beginning, but I was thinking of doing something Valentine's based, and I had some roses I bought at the supermarket a few weeks ago actually that miraculously still going. I put a couple of them in a glass and I thought maybe I'll try something with this, and it just wasn't working for me, so I thought, well, really Valentine's should be about remembering, you know, who you really love in the world. So that's why I thought I'd do a self-portrait, and that's my joke for the evening. I say joke, I mean it's kind of a half joke. Yeah, am I that conceited? I might be. I'm not sure. No, that's leaning inwards. So these angles lying to me because of this weird bendy mirror. There's a couple of my frames up on the hanging up. On the wall. Very steep angles. Yeah, I'm coming down. That's level with the bottom of that easel. And it's steeper than that. There's a chair. I might move up the chair the cat's in so he can get in there as well. He likes to be included in things. the box is going to be quite a useful, move it over a little bit, useful compositional tool. An angle. That's my leg. Okay, starting to get a composition now. I'll chuck a few of those lights back in. I've changed my mind about the whole composition. Hooray! A few lights there. I'm going into the ceiling. I'll soften all this down. I don't want too much white on the surface. It'll throw everything. These aren't too far off. Probably won't fiddle with them that much. There's some on my head. So I'm going to move that. Okay, I'm in now. I don't know how much I can give you a clue as to what it is I'm really seeing in this mirror. I'll see if I can do a little close up. Yeah. If I sit back down. Still pretty teeny in it, but yeah, there I am. So yeah, it's a lot to make sense of. So really, I've got to prioritize. Delay, and I can't see what's happening. There. Back we come. Yeah, so I'm going to take my time with this. I'm not going to rush it. I don't know how much I'll get done in one session, but I'm going to try and take my own advice. Mix plenty of paint, use a big brush. It's taken me a little while just to get to the place where I've got my composition and I know where I want it on the canvas. I'm trying to forget about the fact that I'm using a rather nice linen canvas. how long it took me to stretch it and prime it and get it just how I like it. Because the whole point is you do a painting over the top. But if you're a bit too precious about the painting when you do it, then it won't work. So yeah, I need to clean this palette up and put some better paint out. So that's what's happening now. That white's good. Seen better days. There's some good stuff inside that. Scoop the good paint out. Raw umber, no point bothering with that. Cadmium red, there's a bit there, that's fine. Alizarin crimson, probably the same. No. Alizarin crimson stays open for a long time on the palette, but if this has formed a skin, then I'm well overdue. Prussian blue. It is quite greeny, this. So Prussian blue might not be a bad colour to use. So you get rather a good paint film with it, but it is a bit transparent. Okay. Let's scrape all this off. This is weirdly satisfying. Chunks. That's why I have my box there. Okay, let's get a clean surface here. That's no ultramarine there at all. Get the Prussian blue up. What is left of that black that I can go to. Grand. I don't think I need to go as far as going over it with a Stanley blade, but that'll do for starters. Now I can put the other paint back and figure out just how much I'm going to need. And it's going to be a lot more than what I've got there, doing that for nothing. There's the white. There's the yellow. There's the yellow ochre. So I'll put these on one side, and these paints will be ever so slightly stiffer. Which I quite like to have. Some different consistencies of the same paint. Same with oil, you know, if you leave linseed oil to stand, it gradually thickens up, especially if you stir it, and you get, well, what's called stand oil, which is a thing you can actually buy, but pour this a wash. Yeah, controlling the consistency of the paint is one of the things that you just kind of get your own feel for it by doing it. Introducing the idea, I think, is a really important thing, especially if you're teaching. If I'm teaching, it's something I talk about quite a bit. Starting off thinned and runny and then working in thicker paint and then using transparency by adding oil to it. But really, there's no recipes. You've got to figure it out as you go along. Now, I tidied up all my paint. It was a terrible error. Let's go and fetch it all again. Not really that. Raw umber, which is green. Start. More raw umber. obtrusive, I suppose. Let's do these then. Oh, glorious. Let's put it all out. Plenty of white, and encourage me to mix plenty of paint. Yeah. Get every last bit out of it. Of yellow ochre. Extra. I won't be far away if I need it. Probably a fair bit of raw umber as well. Seems to use quite a lot of that. Definitely use quite a bit of that. The reason I'm wrapping a tissue around it is because I buy the student colour because it's got exactly the same pigment in it, and I tend to weaken the paint down anyway because I don't like that very high pigment load with alizarin. Since we've got very strong staining power, so it's kind of perfect in a way. And it's so much cheaper, it's actually worth it. So you definitely get more pigment for your money with that particular one. But, same with this, they call it Scarlet Lake, but it's actually Natural Red. Oh, a bit more orangey. Yeah, but the tubes are the actual tubes themselves. Not that what's in them is, well, what's in them is cheap as well, but the actual tubes are quite cheap. They've obviously, which I don't mind, if they're going to skimp on the price, you know, make them cheaper, I'd rather they did it with the metal tube it's in rather than, what do you call it, rather than the paint itself. But as a result, it does tend to break open and go all over your hands. A little Windsor boot out there as well. That'll be quite fun. And I've got this orange. Some cadmium orange. This is the first time I've used gambling paint, so I thought I'd give it a try. It's an American make. See how that plays. Okay. Right, here we go. Let's get some mixing done. I'm going to start off with that ceiling. Well, actually, maybe I'll mix a black first. Yeah. I'm going to mix a black. Some raw umber. some ultramarine. It'll give me quite a warm black, slightly greeny. And I'm going to put a bit of Prussian blue and a bit of alizarin in there as well, just so it's extra dense where I need it to be. But I'll only be using that for emergencies. So that's my main service black, if you like. And then just take the excess, put in some Prussian blue, some alizarin. Oh, that's rather violent. In there. That's a super dense dark black. I don't know if you can tell the difference on camera, but you can certainly tell it here. That's going to be useful. And let's do a grey for the ceiling. It's going to be a bit of more of a mid-tone. Now, stupidly, I'm starting with the black, whereas I should start with the white, but I've got a fairly good idea of where it's going to come out. Yeah. There's a grey there. An orangey one. I'm going to make a. It's already bluish there, so that's a bluish light. I'll put that in the middle. And then what's left is going to be a bit of a purpley shadow, which is what I have here. So already I've got nowhere near enough paint mixed, so that's a great start, isn't it? Right. Like I said, I've got quite a well-sized surface, so I'm going to work with oil right from the off. And that's going to go in, I think it's going to go in here. Is that going to be dark enough? No, not quite, but it's a good little sort of border of that light. Do the edges of the room nicely. Yeah, need to do the darks first. So stick a whole load more of that in. Seed oil in it as well. So I'll put this in. Mix it in with a knife. Is that too loose? No, that'll be okay. Then I can mix into it as I go along. Going to go in here. I can already see more reds into it. Now that's going to be browner. Where is it bluer? It's bluer around these edges around here. These edges of the ceiling. Let's plunk them in. red into just that particular brush mix. Purple things up a bit. Carpet will be sympathetic to this. There's an orange that turns up there. As it does over there. Where else has this colour? Got that other window. Top of the window up here. Quite a bit in the carpet. Version. Where's that going to go? You know what? It is greener over here. So while that's on the brush, corner of the palette, going up from there, put some of these shadow colours here. As my hand moves up, that's going to go there. It's not going to make much sense until the lights go in, but definitely some blues in there. So I'll put this in first for the time being. Up here as well. Into there. Right. My bluish light there in the middle. Just using the same brush. That's going to go in here. Has this changed its mind as to where the top of my head's going to be? I think it has. That goes all the way across to the other side of the room. And it leans like this, which is, why that is going to make sense later on. That's too much the same colour as well. And then into the darker, more purpley one. I'm going to use a little bit of that naphthol already. Alizarin's a bit harsh. That works quite nicely for the light at the corner of the room. And where else? Yeah, a little bit in here. A bit of yellow ochre in there as well. That might be too much. Actually, if this is the right colour that I want, which it isn't yet, a bit more naphthol red. I'm just doing this as a brush mix. Once I land it, I'm just going to mix a whole load more because that goes all over. And that's it. That's pretty much it. So let's have a whole load of that. So I had some of those blacks. Mixed a load of grey. And I put some naphthol red in there. And a bit of yellow ochre. That's it. That's a bit lighter. I'll do a light version and a dark version. The dark version can use a little bit more of that warm black and a bit more of the red, actually. No, that's the wrong bit. Thank you. is quite probably not grey enough. We'll see. How's it work for the top of the room? Actually, no, that's fine. Ah, right. So we've got that bit of window there. Goes down to my arm. It's all in a completely different place now. It's all moved. That's the palette, that's the window. This is the wall in between. A bit more of it than I thought. I will put the pictures on it as well. It goes in a straight line up from the top of my head. Curves. And that's going to be where the top of the window is. Which means all of that is smaller. Okay, but I've scrubbed in a colour in the meantime. There you are. I think that was the point. That was the point where everyone was going to get mixing colours. That's where everyone zones out. But there's no way of having them all pre-mixed. Or if there was, that'd be a dreadful hack, and it wouldn't be worth watching. So. Greeny black, just pop it back in there just so you can see where the darks and the lights are. Dark there, which we might be about to move around a bit, but until it does. Okay. It's lighter, it's a bit peachier colour there. Bit of that brown into that blue here, mix it in. That's not dark enough. Make a darker version of that brown. Right up at the edges. Okay, this image is starting to turn up. Use some of that for the back of the canvas as well. And then some of the light for what goes around it, which again, probably carry a bit more yellow ochre with it. start to see my room now. It's interesting how it turns up. I'm going to put a bit more yellow ochre into that dark colour. And then some of that carpet in. Where else does this belong? I can't find anywhere. Maybe on the box. Yeah, it takes rather a lot of concentration, this, so I'm going to give myself a little break now, and I'm going to show you last week's live stream. Not last week's, the week before last, as a time lapse. If you follow my page, you may have already seen it, or actually, if you follow my page, it's quite possible you haven't been shown it, because yeah, it seems to be rather selective. Yeah, definitely time for a break. Yeah, I think I might go into the early hours with this, so do check back in if you're popping in and out. See how I'm getting on. Drop me a message. Tell me something interesting. It's a start. This is with music from Matt as well, so enjoy. Mine doesn't want to play right now. Okay, we'll load it again. Come on. Thank you. Okay. Gonna have to get Matt to make them slightly longer pieces of music. So I've got time to make a cup of tea. Hey, it's just me and you, mate. Oh, I know, someone else has come back. Ah, crunchy bones. Bits in the paint. That's no good, we can't have that. That's somehow got stuck to the ground. Oh, is that loose? I think it might be. Yeah, so I thought I'd do a self-portrait. So I was reminded there's an annual, sort of, well, biannual maybe, I'm not sure, thing with the Ruth Borchard Prize. They have a collection, and every year they do a competition where lots of people pay to enter, and then they have an exhibition with their mates and everyone else's money. So this year I thought I'd do a self-portrait for the Ruth Borchard Prize, and then rather than enter, I'd keep the money and spend it on something nice. So now I've got now I've got something else to look forward to. I don't know what I'll get myself. I might get a pizza in or something. Be good. And you don't get a rejection letter with the pizza, or get to watch lots of people who aren't very good, but I've got the right mates, and we'll join in a bigger, expensive exhibition at your expense. I'm not bitter. but yeah, now I have come to realise if you want to make this stuff happen, you have to do it yourself. To be charging. Are you charging now? Apparently you are now. Hey. Well, I think it's just me and you, Matt, that got that little bit of bile. And now I'm calm. I'm going to be nice. I'm going to soften all these edges, do a whole load of vertical marks. I'll get with a big brush. I need a decorating brush. Just as a little placeholder, I am going to make a nice bright orange for the lights. partly just to see how well this this gambling cadmium orange behaves. Because I'm going to need a context. That's going to go behind here somewhere. Oh, I don't know. I'm not very happy about that. It could be better. No, it's not bad. And I'm working into wet paint as well, to be fair. To be fair. My lights. That's giving them a bit of context now, actually, and that's not bad. I thought they had to get a bit darker, and they do. Yeah, there's no harm in putting some lights in near the beginning. Let's do that now. Right, that's me. That's my arm. This is where the lights for that window start. Sort of up here, and they are more orange. Then they go into the green a bit, and that's the wall. That's about the right size. Come all the way down to here. What's that angle? It's steep, like this. About here. Yeah, there's a gap. And there's this sort of curve. And it would be this greenish colour, and then the corner of the canvas is actually there. There's a reflection of that light in the window. Yeah, I feel like I should be chatting about something else anyway. Okay, that's sort of greener there. Pop some of that in. Again. Once I've got these basic colours on, I can do a bit more of the, let's say, detail, but that's too green. This is sort of an orangey shadow now. Just inside that. That's the light of the room compared to the Yeah, the light of from outside shining off the window, which is going to switch itself off at some point, which will be quite annoying. And we're back to that greeny one, aren't we? Greeny one that's behind here. It's a bit steeper there. Okay. So yes, I'm mostly concentrating on drawing, which means there isn't that much interesting for me to say. Unless it's to do with the drawing. At the moment is quite a lot of measuring. Now thinking about the thickness of paint, which at the moment is quite thin for anyone that's interested, which is no one. Right. Oh, hello, Kurt. Well, I imagine she's been and gone in that time. It seems to tell me how many people are with me, and it seems to be at one, whilst also telling me lots of different people are turning up to watch, so I imagine they're watching for about 4 seconds. But do correct me if you're there, Kirk, say hi. This is a lot lower. A lot lower. Right, so back to my shadow colour. A bit bluer there. Let's pull that down. Any highlights or anything on yet. I'm going to move that canvas now. That's in the way. I need a few harder edges to get structure in. And what about this? I'm going to move that and this. Slightly greenish shadow shapes again. Just gonna come and those lights go on. They should do a little bit of magic. Very difficult to measure this. I'll have to use two hands. One for that, another one for this. And I'm doing it in the reflection. There's one. That's two, takes me to the camera. Madness! Nothing's in the right place. My head's much smaller than I thought it was. It's going to move the window right across. Everything's in the wrong place. Right, what do I do? Do I shrink it? Yeah, certain things survived the first rejig. Tell you what I'm going to do, I'm going to obliterate a bit of it. What's going to go in there? It makes sense one day. There's going to be an arm here, and there's a hand there, and then there's a space here, and then the canvas is right at the edge. It moves further over. So that, it's really deeply confusing. The corner of the canvas is above the top of my head, which is there, which is good. So if I put some dark in around that, it's not even halfway down it. Hang on, where's the bottom? Let's triangulate it. Bottom of the canvas is here, it's moved. Yeah, the palette will be in a different place. Which means halfway down that is the rest of that shape, which comes out at that angle. Ah, some discoveries being made here. Which means we've got the shape there, which means that's window frame, which means that's shadow shape, which is, oh, that's where it was before. No, this is okay actually. Oh, it's very tricky. Very tricky indeed. Too much paint on the surface now. though there seems to be hardly any. Some of that dark there. That is a thin strip. That's a fairly thin strip, and then that's my shoulder. That's where the camera goes.
Yeah.
That camera is actually quite useful. That's the edge of the window. Whew. It's got a corner of the window to my hand on my knee. It's about 45 degrees. Is that the distance there? Okay, yeah, I think I'm starting to find it now. Oh, it's been quite the workout. Something I can do actually is make everything browner in between. And now I've got a surface of paint there. Just work into it, especially up near the corners. All of that can darken down a bit in that corner over there. Bit into the ceiling as well. Let's put a bit in there. Everything's getting a bit browner. There you are. That's my world of brown. Thing about peripheral vision, which kind of turns up with this sort of a concept of a painting, which is interesting to me, that you feel like you're looking at the world, but you're only ever looking at a bit at a time, a bit of it at a time, and what you really see is an illusion your brain creates for you. The real world you're in, you're in the middle of this sort of bubble, and that's what I like about these mirrors, is that they sort of tell you that, and you just have to accept it, even if you don't like it. Okay, I'm going to go into a sort of more purpley light here. Let's have a bit of naphthol red in that. Oh, it's actually down here. Still a long way off bright white, so that may, I'm okay with that. If I move my arm, I can kind of paint in around where my arm goes. Get that curve on there. I'm bored in the background, is actually. actually a bit distracting. So I'll move that along. Better. Yeah, so this is really, it's really just been the start of a painting today. It hasn't been a proper thing. That's so bizarre, because that starts off vertical, that line, and then it actually curves around towards you. That's just bizarre. This here, that's much steeper. And then that never quite straightens up. Paper up on the wall, shall we? Oh, first there was that. A bit hard to obey your eye. So that's the wrong colour, but there you are, that's fine. Drawing pinned to the wall. Here's another one here. We've got a stark blue one over here. Steeper, steeper. There we are. These basic shapes at the moment. I will put thicker paint over the top of these. It defines those okay. The one under there. We've got some idea of where the edge of the window is now. Which puts the top of my palette there, which agrees with what I put earlier. That's good. That's the windowsill height. Some of those greens and things that go in there. And dark on the inside. Phew! Starting to behave. Let's see if there's any more twitch. Says I have one viewer, but that could be me. What about YouTube? Hello, Barbara. Sort of thing, it's really just establishing the room, establishing the space, because it's, like I said, it's quite contradictory. A lot of the time your brain will tell you one thing and your eye will tell you another, and figuring out which one to listen to can be a bit tricky. Okay. Get a medium brush, get some of that dark colour, not really dark, there's already paint on here though, so it won't go really dark. I'm just going to try and establish, it's a warmer dark than that, I'm going to put a little bit of red into it. Naphthol and yellow ochre, just to warm that up. There. This is barely more than a drawing stage at the moment. Just establishing the tones, getting the lights and the darks in. So here, similar kind of thing. Let's put a few darks in there for that. There's that easel. There's the plan chest here. The thing behind it, there's an open door. Oh, hang on. No, that'd be the speaker there. Chest, there's the open door. She goes there to that at the top of the bookcase. That's the dark area for the bookcase there. And there'll be the chair, but I might. That's where I might put the different chair in. Let's just move it over. So we can see the, yes. So we can put the cat on it. And this curve of the carpet, which straightens up pretty quickly. No, it's still at an angle there. Basic shapes are in. Yeah, nowhere closer to the actual self-portrait bit, but hey-ho. Let's take some of that. Let's put some Winds of Blue in it. And, cadmium yellow. That's the edge of the sofa there. Up before I started might have been advisable, but well, where's the fun in that? Okay, now it's starting to wake up a little bit. Definitely need to get a bit more brown into that though. It's not that strong a colour. Maybe a little bit along the top. I'm starting to decide where I'm going to put the detail. And put that door in. Pointing up there. I'm just going to leave this on running for as long as I'm painting tonight. Which probably won't be that much longer, but that door's there, there's a bit of carpet here. A bit on the inside here. A bit of that colour in the door itself. That's going to have to be a bit redder. A bit bluer there. I've definitely got a surface to work into now. Holders. That's going to be my little roll of kitchen towel at the bottom. This is my, where my hand's going to be, which is holding a piece of rag. That's the little slope of my shirt, which sort of catches the light on that side. Yeah, that arm keeps moving around, so I'm going to stop trying to paint that quite so accurately. Arm gets bigger. My big slab of a head. Turn up. Be quiet on what's going on there. There's a few things in that couple of thing. Yes. I haven't even started putting the light on here yet, so when that starts turning up, it should have a nice effect. Time for another break, I think. Don't want to overdo it. Well, I'm massively impressed with myself that I can do this for a year and a half, and I've managed to make sure nobody is interested. And that's quite something, isn't it? I think if I tried really hard to make nobody interested, there'd still be someone. Well, there's always Matt, but he's practicing. Yeah, you'd think there'd be someone somewhere out of 7 billion people that would be interested, but apparently there just isn't. Which kind of takes the pressure off, I guess. Yeah, that's quite fun, isn't it? Anyway, I don't want my camera to overheat either. So I guess I'll probably stop it there. Normally it switches off by itself, but it's not doing that tonight, and I don't know why. Really found some kind of workaround.